I'd like to talk to you about how you manipulate what the photographs that I'm looking at are. It's hard to decide whether I should say to you they're black and white with an apparent wash of color, or whether they are just somehow evolving from the page in different textures. But it does look as if you've washed color, and you've said that in fact that's the alchemist within you. That's the person who creates different chemicals to make different things happen as you develop your own photos.
You know, Sarah, I'm going to just swing it and then swing it back to the chemicals, but it's almost as though I think in each of us there's an alchemist.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can either see something good or bad, and when you make that switch within yourself, whether something's good or bad, you are an alchemist.
Mm.
Okay. So whether you switch it, you're seeing it as bad, you switch it to good, immediately you become an alchemist.
Okay.
You've changed your perception.
Mm.
So back to the what we see outside of ourselves, which is my photographs lying here, they're all done in the darkroom.
Mm.
There is no manipulation. It's a pure chemical process. And again, I attribute everything to the old masters.
Mm.
That's another thing that people have forgotten, is that photography goes way back. Photography didn't just happen now with a digital camera.
No.
It goes way back.
Mm.
And so I studied all the old 1940s American photographers.
Ansel Adams and people.
Yeah,
like
and
that.
Even further back than that.
Really?
Alfred Stieglitz.
Oh, okay.
Who, you know, I always make a mention, and on my center in East London, there's a plaque.
Mm.
The whole building is dedicated to him. And he was quite an eccentric soul. That's probably why I relate to him. But he believed in that photography was reflections of who you are.
Yeah.
And so through studying his work and through studying all, there was a lot of rivalry between the painters and the photographers in the 1940s in America.
Mm-hmm.
And once the photographers came on, because they were metaphorical photographers, and once they came on the scene, once you start, you know, people want to know how I do this. And when you start mentoring, they start getting this glazed look because you mention a date and then they think, oh, history.
Yes. You're going to bombard us with things.
But it's an important thing. So what I did in my thesis was actually combine the painting and the photography to create the perfect art form. So that's ultimately what this is. It's the perfect art form. There is no manipulation. I used to make photographic emulsion out of egg, an ordinary egg. Mixed with potassium dichromate and called the gum bichromate process.
Mm.
But so these five chemicals that I formulated over the past 20 years come from a lot of practicing in the darkroom. You know, today you can click on a switch on the computer and it's called posterization or solarization.
Mm.
But that original process started in the darkroom.
Mm.
That's where it came from.
Mm. There's such a lot of integrity, though, about somebody who still develops their own photographs. It's one thing. And the digital age is fantastic.
It's awesome. It's absolutely awesome.
And it's made photography so much more accessible to so many more people. But there's a lot of integrity about that thing which says, I saw it. I captured that moment. I can live and breathe that moment at any given time. And I've given it a new life. I've given it a new dimension. And seeing that entire process as being something that you're akin to.